Hi, myself, I'm Ratna Bhushan. Welcome to the program, The Great Bharat and the Great People. Good evening, Honorable Prime Minister Ji. This is the program for you and for the people of our nation. It will cover your per day efforts for the betterment of the nation and suggestion for you so that we can make this country more glorious in the whole world. The photograph, what I'm showing in my camera, it has been taken from the Hindu newspaper. Boxers who made all at the Asian Championship during the felicitation ceremony on Tuesday. Boxers who made medals at Asian Championship during the felicitation ceremony on Tuesday. My heartiest congratulations to my Indian boxers when you did great job for India. Congratulations. Before starting the program, I would like to read some of the important article of Indian Constitution. Article 26, freedom to manage religious affair. Article 27, freedom as to payment of taxes for promotion of any particular religion. Article 28, freedom as to alternates at religious instruction or religious worship in certain educational institution. Article 29, protection of minority interest. Article 30, right of minorities to establish and administered education and institution. The most important fact of today is our Washington Pipe Dream. Washington Pipe Dream, American stance and Iranian oil exports could only cause mayhem in West Asia. This article was written by Muhammad Ayub in the Hindu newspaper. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo announced on April 22 that the United States would not issue any additional significant reduction exceptions to existing importers of Iranian oil who had received such exemptions last November. Mr. Pompeo declared that the objective was to bring Iranian oil exports to zero in zero. India, China and Turkey, the principal remaining oil importers from Iran, will feel the greatest impact on this policy, which will take effect on May 2. The end of the waivers is expected to bring different responsibilities from the main importers. China, one of the largest importers of Iran oil. China, one of the largest importers of Iranian oil. China, one of the largest importers of Iranian oil, is likely to defy the American demand because as great power and potential challenger to U.S. hegemony, it will not want to be seen as a bowing to American pressure. Furthermore, Beijing is firmly opposed to unilateral sanction as it fears that one it may be subjected to similar moment. American decisions could not have come at worse time for India, with the country in the midst of a bitterly fought election campaign and policy makers focused on domestic scene. Nevertheless, the Indian response is expected to be the most weak need of the three. Weak need of the three. The New Delhi is likely to comply with American demands, as India's relation with U.S. in the economic sphere are very important to it. The U.S. is India's largest trading partner. And leading source of foreign investment. It has become increasingly important in the strategic arena as well as because of the convergence of American
and Indian interest regarding containing China in the Indo-Pacific region. Moreover, the civil nuclear relation with the U.S. is very important for India, as an American support for India's bid to enter the nuclear supplier group, that is NSG. However, compliance with the American diktat will not come without cost. India is heavily involved in building up the Chabahar port in southern Iran, Chabahar port in southern Iran. This port is expected to become a major access route for India, not only to Iran, but also to Afghanistan and Central Asia, bypassing hostile Pakistani territory. Tehran is also important for New Delhi in the context of Afghanistan, as both are unequivocally opposed to the Pakistan support Taliban returning to power, even in power of the sharing arrangement. Furthermore, Iran shares India's antipathy towards Pakistan. India's antipathy towards Pakistan. Iran shares India's antipathy towards Pakistan, which consider Washington proxy and Saudi Arab's ally. India's decision to stop importing oil from Iran at the America's behest. Why I repeat these words? Because these all are the words which is very, very important for all competitive exams. And if you are while writing something, if you are putting these things, your numbers will America's behest, America behest, B-E-H-E-S-T, America behest, could drive a wedge between New Delhi and Tehran. That will be very difficult. That will be very difficult. That will be very difficult to repair the cost India strategically. The most important question is whether Iran will be capitulate to the American threat of cutting oil imports down to zero and accept Washington demand to revise its position on the issue the U.S. considered important. These include Tehran totally giving up its right to enrich uranium and closing down all the nuclear facilities, including these engaged in research for the peaceful purpose. Additionally, it would entail Iran drastically curtailing of not completely eradicating its ballistic missile program and radically changing its West Asia policy to fall in line with American preferences in Syria, Iraq, Lebanon, and Yemen. However, this appears to be a Washington pipe dream. Iran has stood up unprecedented sanctions for 4 decades and remained unbowed. The current American policy of forcing Tehran to cut its oil exports to zero will only aid American hardliners and end up with Tehran adopting an even more virulent anti-American posture, further implementing the realization of American strategic objective in the region. The next most important from Times of India, celebrating Swachh Bharat Mission. Of all of Modi's projects, it will have the greatest long-term impact on its people's life. This article was written by Mr. Arvind in Times of India. I had two opportunities in a conversation several months prior to 2014 election to discuss with the Chief Minister of the Gujarat, Narendra Modi, the future course of economic and social policy. When it comes with the health sector, I urge him to pay special attention to public health as Prime Minister. I reasoned that over the decades, the government had come deeply into the provision of medical services, which even private sector provided. At the same time, it had neglected public health, which only it can provide. The result, for instance, had been that drainage system of our cities and becoming badly clogged, that even moderate rains resulted in stagnant water bodies that even serve as breeding grounds for vector-borne diseases. I went to add that the old traditions of parents inculcating the children the habit of washing hands first thing after the entering home and before ever meal had also been dying. As Prime Minister, through television broadcast and other media, Modi could exhort parents to return to inculcating good personal hygiene habits in children. Modi listened presently and then said, October 2nd, 2019 will be the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. Why not resolve to give the father of the nation a Swachh Bharat on that day? I did not fully appreciate the significance of what he had said at the time. It was only when I heard him announce in his maiden address to the nation right forward on 15 2000, the Swachh Bharat Mission, understood the name meaning of the word. But this is my personal view, what I am saying about the writer. The Swachh Bharat, no doubt it was not 100% successful, but definitely it created a remarkable sense of humor in the Indian people to make a Swachh their house, to make their environment Swachh, and to make Swachh there, because it could not be possible in one day, because it's a daydreamer. We cannot make it in one day, but the initiation made by Prime Minister Narendra Modi was a big epoch for Indian history and for the Indian era. And only not he can make the clean India, it's a responsibility of each and everyone to make clean everything. भारतीय सेना ने देखे हिममानों के 32 इंच लंबे पदचिन्ह। भारतीय सेना ने हिममानों हिमालय की पहाड़ियों में हिममानों येती के पदचिन्ह देखने का दावा किया। सेना का कहना है कि सैन्य पर्वतारोही के दल ने बर्फ पर पैरों के विशाल निशान देखे। वैज्ञानिक समूह येती को मिथक मानता है, हालांकि नेपाल में इससे जुड़ी बहुत सी कहानियाँ प्रचलित हैं। माना जाता है कि हिममानों हिमालय की ऊँची बर्फीली चोटियों के बीच कहीं रहते हैं। भारतीय सेना ने 3 तस्वीरों के साथ ट्वीट किया। तस्वीरें माउंट मकालू के नज़दीक स्थित एक कैंप के पास खींची गई है। इनमें 32 इंच लंबे और 15 इंच चौड़े पदचिन्ह देखे जा सकते हैं। मेजर मनोज जोशी के नेतृत्व में 18 सैनिकों का दल 2 अप्रैल को माउंट मकालू के पर्वतारोहण पर गया था। वहां 9 अप्रैल को उन्होंने विशाल रहस्यमय पदचिन्ह दिए। सेना ने ट्वीट किया, पहली बार भारतीय सैन्य पर्वतारोहियों ने मिथकीय जीव येति के पैरों के रहस्यमय निशान देखे। सेना ने कहा है, तस्वीरों और वीडियो का विशेषज्ञों के पास परीक्षण के लिए भेजा गया है, जिनसे इनके बारे में ज़्यादा जानकारी मिलेगी। दशकों से लुभाती रही येती की कहानियाँ, लंबे वालों वाले विशालकाय हिममानों की कहानियाँ दशकों से पर्वतारोहियों को लुभाती रही हैं। सर एडमंड हेलरी समेत कई पर्वतारोही इनके पैरों के निशान देखने का दावा कर चुके हैं। 2008 में पश्चिमी नेपाल चढ़ाई से लौटे जापानी पर्वतारोहियों ने भी रहस्यमय पदचिन्हों को देखने का दावा किया था। हालांकि तमाम कैमरों के बावजूद ये येती को कोई तस्वीर नहीं ले सके। अमेरिका में 2 व्यक्तियों ने कहा था कि उन्हें आधे मानव आधे बानर के अवशेष मिले थे। बाद में सामने आया कि ये अवशेष रबर से बने गोरिल्ला के हैं। सबसे ऊंची चोटियों में शुमार है मकालू। माउंट एवरेस्ट सबसे ऊंची चोटियों मकालू। माउंट एवरेस्ट के 19 किलोमीटर दक्षिण पूर्व में नेपाल में स्थित सीमा पर स्थित मकालू दुनिया की पांचवी सबसे ऊंची चोटी है। मकालू दुनिया की पांचवी सबसे ऊंची चोटी है। सो थैंक यू वेरी मच टू वॉच माई प्रोग्राम। विश यू ऑल द बेस्ट। गॉड ब्लेस यू। गॉड ब्लेस इंडिया।